Hello, I'm Mr. Armiger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity because Christianity became corrupt. This is well seen in Pope. When the first church was formed, people sold their properties to join the communal life, which of one God, one faith, and one fold, one shepherd. So they enter the fold of Christ Jesus, which you need to be mammon free, and the fold of the temple priest was full of mammon. Rich people go there, give money. Whereas the royal priest, they give and not take money. Opposite. So it was running okay. So far, it was under the control of the workers, laborers of Jesus. In Jesus, we don't have disciples, because the root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline a natural man through the moral laws of Moses. In the Church of God, we don't deal with moral laws, because moral laws were till John the Baptist. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So prophet come to deliver the law. Moses came, he delivered the law. So any prophet, they all delivered law, and they are the whip master for the rabbis to whip them up, to sharpen them up. But when the rabbi became too crook and materialistic money, they start beating and killing the prophets. That's why, you know, Jesus told them, many prophets were sent to them. You beat them, you maltreat them. And then our father said, let me send my own son. They will recognize him and treat him with honor. So when his son came, they say, hey, this is the heir. This is the one who is the heir of this holiest of holy. And they got hold of him and killed him. So what will the father do then? He will destroy such a nation, which he did in 70 AD. 70 is made up 10 times 7. 10 are commandments, 7 are the works we do, types of works we do. 6 secular, 1 is of our God, which is a philanthropic. The middle candle of the menorah. This is what it is. The middle candle is raised above the other 6 in honor of Christ Jesus. So there you are. This is the right menorah. Anybody who puts the middle candle at the same level as the other 6, they are not honoring Christ Jesus. He is the Lord of the Sabbath, and that's why he is honored by raising the middle candle above the other 6. That means he is now greater than the rabbis. So this book I have written is on the internet, and also you can find ebook which is revised, and if somebody is interested, then he can help me to put a paper version. In Jesus, freely we receive, freely we give. No greedy person, no blood money is required. So, prophets finished at John the Baptist. No more prophet after him. Then it was the matter of heart. In a house there are five, three against two, two against three, that applies. Three are of ego and two are of mind. Ego and mind to be overpowered to purify our heart. And this is here, you know. This is the tribal people. Here, sons of man. Tribal people, sometimes they have ego of their tribe, that I come from this tribe, that tribe. So this ego is to be overpowered, and in this is purely flesh. In flesh you have do the immorality. There we call him calm, immorality. Then spiritual. Once more man can't understand gospel, he gets angry. So anger is the second husband, or the two of ego. This is ego. This is ego. And third ego is here, religious knowledge through book knowledge, as the university professors have. That is number three. And those who are twice born, the mind is open, or they got the Holy Spirit. They are subject to two, greed, temptation, and worldly temptation. Remember, Jesus was taken to a high mountain and shown all the kingdoms of secular kingdoms. And Satan said, kneel down and I will give you all these kingdoms. That is what Pope stands for. Pope was the kingmaker, and he had all the kingdoms under his thumb. So there are three, one, two, and three of ego and two of mind. The mind people are clever. They are simpletons. So the mind clever people fleece a simpleton, and when simpleton get very, very poor, then they beat them up, as in revolutions and other things, you know. So that's what in German, you know, these Jewish people became rich and the local people were poor, so they were very happy to beat them and kill them. So if you are contented, like the Samaritans, there is neither rich nor poor, you are a happy society, as the communists are. In communism, they shared everything, neither rich nor poor. Now, of course, they are very rich people and poor people because of they opened the gate to the West. And the West people are sons of Satan. You can see how they are creating problem in Syria. If there's an election to be held anywhere, British send a delegate, go and see that they are democratically elected. And now in Syria, Assad is a democratically elected president. And they are supporting the rebels because they get money. Saudi Arabia is buying weapons and sending them further to the rebels under the direction of their master, which are in America. They are going to be exposed. Trump is going to do the job. If Trump brings Assange back into the fold, you will see how they will be exposed, because Assange know all their secrets. So prophets, Jesus was not a prophet. He was the very Son of God. The sons of God are called saint. And saint are because when your heart is clean of those five temptations, then you become a saint. Samaritan woman at the well, she had overpowered all those five. Three of ego, two of mind. And the last husband that was with her but not dominating her, that was spiritual knowledge she learnt in spirit, Holy Spirit, not by the dead letters. That is why she engaged Jesus into deep, deep discussion that even surprised his own laborers. They kept quiet. And that was the last husband living with her, no more her husband. And that's why she told Jesus that you are a prophet. But when Christ come, that means she knew Christ is greater than prophet. When Christ come, he will tell us everything. And that Jesus was so pleased with her that to the others he was telling them not to tell that I am the Christ. To her, he pleased because she was a jeweler. And she had valued the Jew. That Jesus said, I am the one, I am the Christ. To the men, people who are light, they can see, perceive Christ. And they were so happy to receive him in their village. To the blind man, if you tell that you are a Christ, you are making fool of yourself. And Jesus, when he was in the temple, he asked those Pharisees, Sadducees sitting there, whose son is Messiah? Messiah stands for Christ, Christ stands for his word. He said, Messiah is the son of David. David is concerned with this flesh, not the inside. So Jesus said, I was before David. I was before the creation, before Adam and Eve. The people over there who were once born, full of ego, of letters, hey, this man, 35 years old, he say, I'm before Abraham. How could it be? Even Jesus told them, you know, look, you killed a Kohen between temple, this temple and that place, you know. You killed him in the temple. And they knew it, they killed it. And even Jesus told everything about that, you know. But still, they were laughing at him. So Jesus, when he told them that I am the Messiah in the temple, so they made a fool of him. So that is what Jesus said. Don't tell that I am a Messiah. A jeweler will know the value of the jewel. And hope you enjoyed this video and always think spiritually. And here's something I've written. Prophets being the law keepers, they are subject to sin, but there's no more law and no more law and sin after John the Baptist. Messiah is the son of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, and he has domination over nature, because our Elohim is our supernatural father. And Yahweh is our natural father. So supernatural is greater than the natural. Natural father produces natural person. And by the grace of our supernatural father that you get Holy Spirit, which is common sense, and then you know him. Domination over nature and sin. But test people, for the quality of their hearts. Now is the quality of your heart that counts. No more law and no more sin. Going against the Holy Spirit is called blasphemy. So those people who are cheat, they know they are going to cheat somebody. But they are hypocrites. They will tell something different as these politicians. They say to the public, sugar-coated sermon they deliver. Same as the dog-collar priest, which are the neo-rabbis, worse than those rabbis from the yoke of which Jesus set us free. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. And they are the ones who are creating sectarian riots in the world. So after John the Baptist, there shall be five in a house, three of ego against two of mind, and two of mind against three of ego. So tell me the names of the five, please. The people, you know, they sometimes challenge me here and there. They haven't done the homework. And so I put this thing to them. There is the This is the sun, primary source of light. Christ is the sun of primary source of light. A son represents Father. So he represented our supernatural Father. The reflection of sun goes to the moon. Moon is this, our physical body. Sun is in sunlight goes to our heart. So moon, then it reflects. This is called oral Torah, oral Torah. If you don't have the oral knowledge of oral Torah, you are not efficient rabbi. But when they became greedy, this was cut off. This light disappeared. That's why on Sabbath, which is supposed to be a day devoted to the philanthropic work of our Father, they were objecting, hey, nobody can work on Sabbath. The doctor sitting at home doing next to nothing because it is Sabbath, not even making a cup of tea. Even today, you know, if your house catches fire, you are not supposed to put it off because it is involved work. And the people rang their rabbi, what shall we do? Our house is on fire. He said, call the fire brigade. By the time the fire brigade came to, more houses got burnt. So this is what Jesus said, Holy Spirit, which he bring to us from our Father. Holy Spirit giveth life. Letter killeth, spirit giveth life. Letter, by the letter they were waiting for the rabbi to give the order whether they should put it off or not, what they should do. And the doctor sitting at home doing no philanthropic work, and the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person and looked after him. The other two might have passed by because it was Sabbath. So they don't want to touch the dying man. So this is the death in letters. Letter killeth, spirit giveth life. And our Father God bless you. You shall start preaching gospel. You may make mistakes, but slowly you will ponder over it. Renew your inner man. The Christ. Inner man is Christ. Because this is the temple of God. The temple, the royal priest of God is sitting here in my heart, called royal priest. So in Jesus we are royal priest. And those who are under, still under the domination of the dog-collar priest, they are super blind, good for nothing. They are wasting their life. And the guide, blind guide, is turning stones, simple-minded people devoted to God, turning stone into bread, living in a big house and driving a car supported by the stooges or the stones in the church. His job is to please the people. He is like a jester, mocking, making them laugh. And that is what they do in churches. Once the people are laughing, they are happy. Their congregation is happy. Hey, that priest is very good. He tells us very nice jokes. That is all he is for. Not for preaching gospel, because he is a hireling dog-collared priest. Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. You can't get anything out of him. So our Father God blesses you.